Om Sri Sai Ram. Prashanti Sandesh, Sai Pearls of Wisdom welcomes you. I very well remember Professor Gokak, the first Vice Chancellor of Sri Sathya University, telling that miracles happen, miracles are not performed. Those that are performed can be branded under magic. And things are performed to draw attention. But the miracles that happen on their own are divine and spiritual. Because divine has none else to attract, because he is in everyone. And the divine is born with all these faculties and capacities. They are not acquired. In that sense, Bhagavan Baba, miracles can be branded as happenings and not as doings in any way. There are so many methods adopted as we watch. Maybe materialization of sacred ash or even surgical instruments. But one thing is certain, all these miracles are medically inexplicable. Can you ever imagine that an eye problem can be solved with jasmine flowers? Can jasmine flowers solve an eye problem? Very strange. Very strange. It is mentioned very clearly and duly verified by contacting the person, an event as follows. It was T.N. Natarajan from Ernakulam, Kerala, who was an active member and a taxi owner. As ill luck would have it, he got his left eye damaged. With the result, he lost sight. He was advised to go to Bangalore. Then in Bangalore, he consulted two specialists, but left with no hope. Further, they said, the left eye is already damaged, and there is every possibility of right eye also may get damaged. In that desperate condition, at the residence of his cousin, he happened to see a photo of Bhagavan Sri Sathya Sai Baba. On coming to know about him, he immediately arrived at Madras. And at that time, Swami was staying there. He was trying to hand over the letter to Swami. And Swami said, don't worry, I know the problem. And then further Baba said, you come to Puttaparthi and you may have to stay there for about 10 days. Accordingly, this gentleman Natarajan came to Puttaparthi as per the instructions of Bhagavan. Each morning, what Baba did was, a string of jasmine flowers tied to the patient eyes and change every day like that. And at the end of 10-day course treatment, Swami called him into the interview room, materialized a bottle of eye drops. and just have put them into his eye. And materialized for him a Rudraksha mala and told him how to make use of it. Well, improvement started, eyesight restored, no more damage, nothing whatsoever. Why this miracle is narrated now is, it's a wonder how jasmine flowers could be of cure to an eye damage. Likewise, I can also tell you another incident. Of course, there are evil spirits. There are many people who deny the presence of evil spirits. But we come across those who are possessed by evil spirits. They act in an incoherent way, in a very funny way. They are not normal. Their actions are abnormal. And their talk is irrelevant, possessed by evil spirit. They're all wild in their action. This is what evil spirit is. When this person by name Krishnan came to Bhagavan, Swami just looked at him and he became normal. No longer the effects of the evil spirit. Here, what was the treatment? Just darshan. Earlier, jasmine flowers. See, this is all unbelievable. I also remember another incident. Dr. D.S. Chandar from Bangalore. Well, this doctor himself had some problem in the gallbladder as some stone was suspected. With the result, he was suffering from acute pain. And that doctor, Dr. D.S. Chandar, came from Bangalore to Puttaparthi. Looking at him, Swami said, "You surgeons think of knives, forks and surgery. Oh doctor, you are a patient now," that Swami remarked smilingly and told him clearly, "You take this vibhuti, mix it some water and take it every day. The stones in the gallbladder disappeared. No more of pain." And here in this case, we find vibhuti being remedial to the problem. But at the same time, I can also tell you, Swami did certain surgical operations also. He operated. Those who are familiar with Sai literature will be remembering that long back, when a person was suffering from some serious problem, abdominal region, and he was just lying down in the veranda of Prashantanayam. He was just sleeping. Next morning, he saw some cotton and some bleeding. What? He saw that he was operated already, some cotton kept on the operated portion. People gathered around and asked him what happened. He said that Swami appeared in the early hours of the morning and did the operation. Baba, the surgeon. It's really unbelievable. Now I can also draw your attention to another instance. You know, a boy by name Sivakumar, just 14 years old boy, he had some heart trouble. And adding to this, he had cerebral spinal meningitis. And this boy came to his uncle's house by name Raman. And doctors also noticed that he was suffering from partial paralysis. Naturally, his sight and speech were affected. At one time he was even unconscious, turned blue, and doctor said he is left with few hours to survive. At that moment, this boy, Sivakumar, started showing some signs, some indications that he wanted to have bath and vibhuti. Accordingly, since the end is fast approaching, the near and dear people gave him bath and gave him some vibhuti. And then the boy was also indicating that he wanted a photograph of Baba. That was also given to him. Then this boy, Sivakumar, 14-year-old, what he did was, he rubbed the paralyzed left part. He rubbed vibhuti on the paralyzed part, left side. What? Got off. No more. The boy who had got partial paralytic attack could not stand, could not speak. He got up now. He walked to the puja room. All the vision is again restored. That is miracle of Bhagavan Sri Sathya Sai Baba. His vibhuti solved the whole problem. Staying far away from Prashanti Nilayam. All this had happened. And Swami appeared in the dream of this boy and assured him that he will take care of him. That assurance and the application of vibhuti brought all the relief to Sivakumar. And another thing is this. There is usually what happens is the husband will have lesser belief while the wife will have more of belief. But in this case, reverse. The couple are a Parsi couple. They belong to Parsi faith. Wife had no faith at all in Swami. But what happened? They have the only daughter, Patel, 2.5 years, by name Ketu. Parsi couple's child is Ketu, 2.5 years, who could not speak. And could not even stand. And they made use of many medicines, but no use. Then people started saying that it's all mental retardation, a special child. Some even said there may be some nervous disability. At that stage, the husband decided to go to Puttaparthi. The wife said, let's not go, it's a waste of money and time. But husband insisted. They went there. It was Shivratri time. And he was trying to give a letter, but he could not give. Because he was feeling that, why should I give the letter to the one who knows everything? When he knows all my problems, why should I give any letter? That was his feeling. So every time he writes and tears the letter, because he understood there's no meaning in giving that letter to the all-knowing. And Shivratri concluded, and Swami made one of the ashram people to make an announcement that there'll be no more interviews for some days to come. And the people, big crowd gathered there, may slowly disperse. This man desperately waited all these days. And when this announcement is made, he had to return. But at that time Swami gave darshan from the balcony of the temple. From the top. He could see Swami. He was very jubilant because he could see all the splendor, all the light in Swami. Somehow he was feeling assured that his problem would be solved. And this Parsi man, Rusi Patel, a Parsi man, returned home. What happened? He saw his little child Ketu running towards him, saying, "Daddy, Daddy, Daddy." That little girl, who could not speak or even stand, and today comes walking and saying, "Daddy, Daddy." This had happened in Bombay. He was so happy. And then, after a couple of days, when he went for Swami's darshan, at a time when Swami was in Bombay, he was sitting in the midst of a big crowd. Swami, while giving darshan, could recognize this couple and could recognize this child, called her close, blessed her with vibhuti and had put it in her mouth. What a wonderful blessing it is. And that child started speaking from then, started walking from then, who initially could not speak or even stand. As it is said in Bhagavad Gita, Mokam karoti vachalam pangum langhayate girim. Lame could climb the mountains. The dumb can speak by the grace of God. That's what our Bhagavan did. These are the wonders that are thrilling, exciting. Such that when we listen to this, we get charged. Our devotion grows. This is all what Sai Bhagavatam is. Sai Bhagavatam contains these stories, experiences, only to develop our faith and grow more in devotion. See you next. Sai Ram.